It's a good question, Amar, and thank you so much. Good morning, everyone. Sorry for being late here. And forgot your name, sir. Naresh. Naresh made very emotional statements, and I think for a pretext, let me just touch base on those points, what he has expressed, if you will. Just, you know, what is my viewpoints and how we can speak, how we could probably, you know, have a temporary solution, at least my thoughts, my views. It may take, you know, a lot of collaboration and policies and process changes. But, you know, honestly speaking, you know, we respect the colleges, we respect institutes, and we do respect because we're all the byproducts of these institutes in Andhra Pradesh, right? So we have been successful, and what he's trying to express is, you know, how we can get that head start. We don't have to go through these many years of trouble or struggle to get where we want to be, where we want to reach in our careers. So how do we get start, the head start, where they can be successful day one when we all graduate from the colleges? So to that extent, I think, you know, we could talk about, you know, what is industry needs. You know, basically, if you look at me or look at any other respected panelist here from the college or from the institutes or industries where they're trying to look at simple skills, right? You know, how technology is definitely required. You know, what technologies, you know, like Amar has been asking, Java, you know, SAP, web development, all that. That is given. That's, you know, basic hygiene. Why companies are coming to India, or for that matter, Hyderabad or any other centers in India, is that, you know, skills you require. Labor arbitrage, right? Basically, it's labor arbitrage. It's commodity, right? How we can sustain this arbitrage and move up in the value chain. So we need to be keep on evolving, right? Keep on, you know, like you said, disseminating information, disseminating what industry needs. So how do you collaborate? So basically, on a continuous basis, how industries, academia, and government can collaborate with industries and see, you know, what are the requirements, you know, what are the skills, what are the communication skills, what is teamwork, how you think, you know, how you communicate, basic communication skills. That's one. And what is industry, I mean, education institutes need? They have huge gaps, right? You know, everybody, I mean, one is they want probably pride, ego, you know, all that, political power, make money and all that. But besides that, you know, what are things they need? Why they can't, you know, able to produce what industry needs? One is economies of training. You know, what is, who is the fulcrum in a college? It's basically the instructors, right? The faculty. They are the fulcrum, isn't it? You know, so what is the eligibility? How do we train them so that they can produce the best talent? They are the machinery, right? You are the byproduct. You are, you know, they're producing you. So how do you make them fit or you know, enable them to produce the right products, goods, so that you could be, you know, productive or effective or efficient the day one? So that is the fulcrum, I think, you know, which is critical, and how we can invest in them, either, you know, selecting criteria, how you train the trainers, how you, you know, interact with the industries and all that. And second is osmosis. It takes time. You know, how do we at least, you know, have a first baby steps, how industries or government can come up with process, policies. What is the framework, right? Basically, we need to create some framework. You know, basically, for a framework, you need, you know, some sort of strategy and then implementation and also audit. And we can create a framework. You know, we can have a further discussions. If this government is interested and the academy is interested, we can sort of, you know, work together to develop that framework. Where I think the missing link is also is audit. Are we doing audit? You know, just audit is, you know, you have labs. I don't know what audits they do in the colleges. You know, labs or, you know, people are good enough for, are they coming to colleges on a regular basis? Or, you know, you have enough labs for them to, you know, probably practice upon. But we should also do audit. How many of them are really becoming employable? You know, how many of them got employed? How many of them really got, you know, went through this training? And, you know, what are the internship opportunities in the colleges, in industries, so that they know what is industry requires, right? Let's make it mandatory. And also make sort of, not mandate, but come, you know, make a policy or a kind of mandate where industries are forced to at least take certain percentage of colleges people to provide, you know, internship programs or sort of, you know, work in industries on a temporary projects or internship or anything, so that those percentage of people or population students can go back in the colleges and sort of disseminate or help the other college, other students. What does it requires? So it's a huge problem for us, I'm sure, you know, but India is way ahead. So that's, I mean, greatness about India. Being coming out of these colleges, we're still successful. But again, you know, maybe 10% is not too small of a number. I was going through a McKinsey report. It's actually 25 or 30% of the graduates coming out of, it's India level, I mean, not Andhra Pradesh, are employable. And maybe 10% are non-engineering graduates are employable. So if you take real engineering graduates, it's 30%, you know, somewhere in 30% are employable, right? And to that extent, you know, IBM is doing a lot of programs from, you know, with collaboration with NASSCOM, reinventing education, many, many programs we are collaborating, investing, where it makes difference, not at a high level, but at the foundation level in schools, in primary schools. You know, give them tools where kids are sort of, you know, exposed to technology, this programming, internet and everything, and also teachers training, train the trainers, how we can train the teachers so that they can produce right goods. So those seven. So that's a little, you know, my thoughts, my viewpoints on that. I'm not sure if you know, everybody appreciates, but anyway. So coming back to Amar's question, yes, you know, it's evolving, it's changing. More than technology, Amar, if you will, we should focus on, you know, if anybody, if there was a survey, right, CEO survey, they said, what is that one skill that requires a person to be successful in their careers? What do you think the answer would be? Just I'll just ask anybody on the audience here. What is that one skill? Good luck? Okay, good one. Hard work? Okay. Hard work is sorry? Commitment. Okay, fantastic. Change? Reliability? Passion? Ethics? Those are all, I mean, those are the values of our company, IBM. You know, commitment, passion, attitude, ethics, values. It is, you're coming, you know, close. You know, we have three, we're making, you know, our clients successful, right? You know, personal responsibility in every relationship, not just, you know, your employee, right? But your friends, families, you know, cousins, brothers, sisters, not beyond your work. But people skills, fantastic. I mean, excellent. So you're smart people, see? You already know what to do. That is what they're looking. That's exactly what they're looking, right? If you really look at, besides technology, besides, you know, the aptitude and all that, these are the skills, you know, teaming, attitude, commitment, hard work, personality, you know, working with the teams, and how can you make yourself successful and your team successful and your employer successful. More than anything else, your client successful. So unless you make your client or customer successful, you're not going to get your business right. You're not going to sustain in the business. So that attitude, I mean, somebody said attitude, right? But one, the answer to come back to the question, it's communication skills. You are right, sir, absolutely. They said communication skill is number one skill for a person to be successful. So we need to focus on that. And then you cannot, overnight, you cannot change your communication skills, isn't it? So how do you change that? How do you come, when you finish your education, when you come out of college? I went to Telugu medium, but I think my communication skills are, you know, decent enough for us to understand. But it took, you know, some years, right, for me to change. So how do you think, you know, it'll happen? Somebody, students, you know, you guys look like students. What do you think, you know, when you finish your graduation, you should be able to communicate? What does communication mean, basically? Expressing? Absolutely. Right.
I run 5 business schools, and I can assure you, most of the students I train, they come from around 200 cities, to Indore, Ahmedabad, and Nasik, where I run my business school. I really wish I could train them in schooling all over again.
Absolutely.
Because at the postgraduate level, the companies expect communication skills. Most students have absolutely rotten communication skills, even from good schools. Good schools, the only differentiator they have is that students can perhaps speak well.
Right.
You give a 2-minute speech and you ask the student to write down what he has just spoken, and you will see that half of what he has written is very wrong.
Right.
So what are the schools doing?
Exactly. I mean, so we can always keep on saying, you know, who's doing what, you know, how we can blame, right? We can always do that blame game. But I'm not saying you're blaming, but, you know, at the same time, what is that we are supporting, we are doing, where we can make some difference. So I mean, to answer your question, sir, you cannot change your destination overnight, but you can always change your direction overnight, right? So we need to sort of, you know, inspire people to change the direction overnight, what they are doing, how they can change, what else they can do to reach their destination, their goals. So we need to focus on that. So probably you can go and tell in the schools, hey, you know, how we could improve, how you could become successful. So like you said, communication just doesn't mean that how you can articulate or how you can speak. It's also how you listen, right? Do you understand the question, what the other person is saying? So that is also part of communication. So also written, verbal, you know, understand business lingo, what is, you know, client is saying. So a lot of times, you know, we just, you know, before even they finish their question, we, you know, come up with answer. We come up with our own viewpoints, right? So that's the culture. It's nothing wrong. That's how we are brought up. That's how, you know, we have raised. That's how we have, expected. So you answer before you question, that means you're intelligent. You know, in your classes, you know, when I was a kid, this is, you know, many years ago, you're about running out, huh? Okay. So we said, you know, I mean, before the teacher would ask question, we raise and we answer, right? So you want to be, you know, seen as an intelligent guy, number one, right? Number one in the class. But we don't, you know, teacher does not say, hey, let me finish my question. You need to understand exactly what I'm asking, right? Then you respond. So that discipline, you know, we can train the trainers. In other words, we can go to colleges and say, you know, this is the, you know, thing what industry needs. So we can do it at each, every level, schools, colleges, intermediates, universities and all that. But in the end of the day, so answer your question, if I can answer this question actually, it is evolving. So you have to have a well-rounded skills. When I'm interviewing, for example, when I go to colleges, whenever I go, I don't go very often. I used to go many years ago. Once they pass the technology, you know, technical exam and all that, I look at communication attitude. Simple two things, right? Is the person is willing to change, has the right attitude to work hard, to change him or herself, to work in a team. Good luck and wish you well.